and I simply remove the telephone jack and plug it into this box here, the modem. I then take another wire from the modem and plug it in where the telephone was. I can then switch on the modem. It's now telling me to phone up the main Presell computer.
So it's a very simple connection to make.
Extremely simple. I'm now waiting for the computer to answer me. And
things are starting to happen.
Things are starting to happen.
Why did you buy a computer?
Well, I was very interested in the new technology and didn't want to be left behind. I don't think it's only for the youngsters at school now. I think us older ones will have to learn a lot about it.
What is internet anyway?
Internet is that massive computer network, mm-hmm. The one that's becoming really big now.
What do you mean? That's big? How does one... What do you write to it, like mail?
No, a lot of people use it and communicate. I guess they can communicate with NBC writers and producers. Allison, can you explain what internet is?
The world is in financial disarray. Currencies failing, economies in wild flux, jobs being lost. But what if you could build an entirely new economy, one specifically designed for the digital realm? Well, that is the dream behind Bitcoin.
Bitcoin, for those of you who don't know, is an electronic online currency that was created in 2009. It was made by someone who did it under the pseudonym Satoshi Nakamoto.
Like any economy, you don't want too much too fast because then the value of your currency drops, or so slow that your economy grounds to a halt. It's designed to be a self-stabilizing economy. Whether it actually is that way, though, well, that is a little bit more complicated.
Because some people have said, hey, Bitcoin is the answer to those problems. Are you a believer?
Well, Bitcoin is exciting because it shows how cheap it can be. Bitcoin is better than currency in that you don't have to be physically in the same place. And, of course, for large transactions, currency can get pretty inconvenient.
And what is Bitcoin? Bitcoin is a currency on the internet.
I sent 100 euros worth of Bitcoin from here in Tokyo directly to you guys through this camera, through the network, through the TV, right into your home. If I had tried to do that, send you the money with a traditional bank, it would have taken several days and probably cost 30 euros. I just did it right now with Bitcoin instantly, basically for free, and didn't have to ask anybody for permission. I didn't need a bank, I didn't need a government, I didn't need anybody. I just needed myself and you and our smartphones to do it. That's the power of Bitcoin.
You can buy Bitcoin at the Shell station. Check it out. Good. Got $2. Hit finish. Oh. $2 of Bitcoin. Just like that. From this machine. I just turned cash into digital currency.
So thinking that it's too late to get involved in Bitcoin is like thinking it's too late to get involved with the internet or too late to get involved with using a cell phone. Like, it's not too late to get involved with Bitcoin. If Bitcoin becomes really popular all over the world, Bitcoins are gonna have to be worth at least tens of thousands of dollars of Bitcoin, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars per Bitcoin. So thinking it's too late to get involved with Bitcoin is like thinking it's too late to get involved with using the internet. Of course not. Like, it's ubiquitous in our lives, and Bitcoin's gonna become ubiquitous in our lives as well.